Before I start reviewing this film, there is a little something I gotta do.
Hey! You son of a bitch!
Okay, much better now. Ooh. Yeah. Hey everybody, this is 22 Tiger Dude and I'm here to review The Purge: Anarchy. The film stars Frank Grillo and the film is about the 6th annual Purge, and this couple end up in the middle of the street when gas on their car goes out, so they have to try to survive. Meanwhile, there's another story with the mother and the daughter and them having to go out and hide. Frank Grillo's character, he saves the couple and the mother and daughter, so all of them tag along with Frank Grillo. If you guys have seen my movie review for The Purge, I thought the film was, it's just okay. It's not a good film, and I do understand the amount of hate that the original film had. It did have dumb characters and, you know, the film had some silly stuff, but I mean, the film did have some intense moments. Ethan Hawke was good, and that's why I just thought the film was, it's okay. The sequel, though, I was not looking forward to seeing. It just looked really stupid from the trailers, and the first thing I wondered to myself was, why is there a sequel? And then I thought to myself, the original film made a ton of money in the box office. You know, a little cha-ching, so here you have it. It doesn't matter how negative the reviews for the original are, you still got yourself a sequel. I'm going to be honest, I really did not like this film. I hated this film, actually. It really just lowered down in quality from the original. The Purge: Anarchy is a very bad and unnecessary sequel. The sequel has nothing to do with the original, there's no mention with the original, so even if you haven't seen the original, you would be okay just seeing the sequel. This time around, this sequel does star Frank Grillo. So far, the thing I have to credit for both of the Purge films is that they actually both have very good male leads. Ethan Hawke was pretty much the best part about the original, and Frank Grillo by far is the best part of this bad sequel. He was the character I was connecting with throughout the whole film, the character I was actually really rooting for and starting to feel sorry for, especially for what happens towards the end when we actually go a little in depth to him as to why he's doing that certain something without spoiling anything. There are only a few action scenes that I actually did enjoy from the film, and there are a few very stupid lines in this film that actually did make me laugh. My negatives with the sequel is that the characters are more dumb this time around. It's just like the characters just didn't have common sense. Okay, I think the son is just slightly more dumber than these characters, the son, the original, but the characters in the sequel, my god, they are just wow. There wasn't really much of a story to get invested in, like you had the rich and the poor stuff. That was kind of intriguing. There's also some very stupid lines from the characters, just very cheesy ones. Like I said, there are a few lines that actually did make me laugh because of how stupid it was. The other dialogue, it just felt so out of place, and it just made me cringe and go, oh my gosh. Also, the purgers for the film just kill to kill. Like in the original film, I can understand why these group of purgers were actually out to kill. Like, at least they actually have a reason. In the sequel, the group of purgers don't have any reason. They're just out to kill. Like, if they see an innocent person, they'll be like, oh, let's kill that guy. Oh my gosh, this is so much fun. Let's go kill that guy. Not only that, but there's a stupid thing where they're just going around in slow-mo. Like, when the couple first meets them, they're just standing there and they're moving around like all slow-mo and all looking all badass and all. It's just all like, that's not badass, that's just stupid. And then there was another moment later on where they just appear but they just stand there, move around a little, and don't do shit. And other than a few action moments, which I did enjoy, most of the action scenes is shaky cam, close-up shots. And it just got really distracting. One of the good things about the original is that some action scenes were really intense. They actually did have me at the edge of my seat. Not very good editing to it. The pacing of the movie itself isn't very good either. It's actually pretty bad because it rushes through one moment. Like, we're all of a sudden at this location. Then they're at this location. Then this certain situation happens. I gotta admit, the final 10 minutes was actually pretty good. That's another positive I have to mention. I'm not gonna spoil what happens. But it was actually quite intense. It actually had me a little bit disturbed. That's the only thing this film does better at than the original. Because in the original, how it ended was pretty stupid. It was so sloppy. And this sequel, while a bad sequel, at least it has a pretty good finale. It was quite stupid, but compared to the other events I've seen in the original, I at least handled a little bit of the stupidity in the finale. I didn't have much reason to care for the couple, honestly. There will be a couple of times where I cared for them, but just didn't have any reason to care for them. And same for the mom and the daughter. I didn't care for them. The daughter got on my nerves a little bit. Overall, The Purge Anarchy is one of the worst films I've seen this year. The original was mediocre at best, but this one was just flat out bad. The Purgers just kill for no reason. It was really dumb. The dialogue was stupid. The writing was terrible. The storyline was bad. The pacing felt very out of place. I'm going to give The Purge Anarchy 1.5 out of 4 stars.
I am 22 Tiger Dude! Don't forget that I will always have Tiger Power!